Hello, everyone. Hate starting to show off on a sad note. We've had some more significant losses this year already. It's only January 10th, folks, and it's really sad, but we lost an absolute gospel legend, Andre Crouch. This guy was amazing. Died very young, pretty young. I couldn't believe he was 72, but July 1st, 1942, he was born. Passed away, a heart attack, January 8th, 2015. Only 72. I guess older than I expected, but older than I thought. I didn't realize he was that old, but wow. Still a very sad loss indeed. Andre Crouch, legendary gospel performer. He will be sorely missed. We also, this one really broke my heart. This guy was awesome, but sadly he can't live forever. But this guy, Rod Taylor, one of my all-time favorite movies, The Time Machine from 1960, George Powell classic. He played the lead actor, the main actor in the movie. Of course, Yvette Mimieux, former Baby of the Day on Barron Song of the Day. She was the she was only 18 in this movie, and she was the leading lady. Rod Taylor, also featured in Twilight Zone. Incredible actor. Born January 11th, 1930. Passed away January 7th, 2015. He was 84, just almost 85 years old, 4 days short of 85. But he is definitely, definitely, definitely going to be missed. And then, of course, just read about this one last night. Roy Tarpley died much too young at the age of 50 after he had been banned in the NBA for drugs. And sadly, was never able to get past his demons. But Roy Tarpley, I heard he was actually a very good man. He just had some demons in his life, you know. But born November 28, 1964, passed away January 9, 2015 at the much too young age of 50. Big man Roy Tarpley, he's definitely going to be missed as well. So moment of silence, please, for our dearly departed, as we will never forget them. All right. Well, folks, can't have the show on a sad note, although right now today's football game has been very sad. All right, let's get the show on the road. Hello, everyone. It is indeed Saturday, January 10th in the year of our Lord 2015. How are you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome, although not as awesome as usual. Patriots. They have tied it up against an evil, rotten, inbred, douchebag, cocksucker, Baltimore Ravens. I hate that freaking team. So, you know what? We're going to play a great song. Drink, Drank, Drunk. Hell yeah! Great song to start the show off right. Today's unofficial sponsor of our show is a true metalhead and a very dear friend of mine, Kevin Sherman of Kevinator's Booze and Metal Show. Folks, if you don't follow that show, you need to. You don't even have to be a metalhead to follow that show, although it doesn't hurt to do that. Kevin and his Booze and Metal Show, trust me, go check it out. You won't be disappointed. Kevin Sherman, you're a hell of a guy. And brother, thank you for your assistance with this week. Smash Metal Saturday! Because I feel like smashing shit right now. I really do. God, I hate the Baltimore Ravens. Alright, well, you know what? Screw it. I can't beat them. Get drunk. Let's do it. A little bit of home-style pride right here. Sam Adams out of Boston, Massachusetts, Sports Space in the Nation. And I've never had this here beer. Sam Adams, Tetravis, T-E-T-R-A-V-I-S. It's a bold Belgian-style quadruple with rich notes of currants, raisins, and cloves. Holy shit. 10.2% alcohol by volume. You know what? If my Patriots are going to lose, then I'm going to lose my sobriety as well. Let's get fucked up. Yep, might as well. That's what I'm doing. You got to bring in a big beer consumption apparatus for this one. Let's bust this fucker open.
Gronk spike!
Hopefully Gronk can come back and win. Five beer winning apparatus right here. Proper technique.
Right now, there's only two reasons that we showed up here. Right now. 45 grand right into the big assumption apparatus, right on the keyboard. Something's that damn good. Haven't felt dropped yet. Never have, never will. We got a lot of birthdays to get to in a moment, folks. Our January 9th birthdays and today's birthday for January 10th. Right after I pour this here beer. 25.4 fluid ounces of beastage. Oh my god. I think I'm gonna die after this one. More than double the strength of a normal beer. Cheer the beer for all of you crosses, say Jeremy Kapai as they say in Japan. Oh, this is good. Oh my god, this is good. Yep, from the Sam Adams Big Ass Badass collection. I give this a big solid A. This is awesome. Yeah! Alright, folks. So we got a lot of birthdays. Let's get cracking right off the bat with yesterday's birthdays. My man, Draco Druid. Is it Draco or Draco Druid? Draco Druid McDaniel. Milestone birthday to you from yesterday.
What's up, brother?
How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Badass Comical Nav Wizard. I work with down here.
Yeehaw, Texas.
Otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. Pretty much the same state. And happy milestone birthday, brother. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Good hearing from you today. And definitely missed the hell out of working with you. But brother, keep in touch. And hope you have a wicked awesome day. And happy birthday from yesterday. Celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers to you. Ah, next on the list. Let's bring up some more music. It's a long one. Oh, Black Sabbath with Dio. How about that? Ronnie James Dio singing with Black Sabbath, Heaven and Hell?
Hell yeah!
It's a long one, so kick back and enjoy. Had to go with a live version. Couldn't find anything recorded, so I had to go with live, which is fine. But next birthday, how about my friend Baron Lucas? Baron Lucas, B-A-R-E-N-D. Fellow mafioso on the old Mafia Wars. What's going on? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope your birthday was phenomenal yesterday. Hope you have another great day today. But celebrate well and enjoy and cheer the beers to you. Next on the list, my man Calvin Brown. Calvin Brown, fellow distant cousin on the old Karis side of the family. What up, Karis? How you doing, Calvin? Happy birthday to you from yesterday. Love playing in the old trivia crack. It's a lot of fun there. And Calvin, my man, hope your birthday was phenomenal. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy it. Cheers and beers to you. Unless you're underage, of course. Here's a man who's not underage, my man Lou Reyes. Luis Reyes, Lou Reyes. Yo, what up, cuz? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Badass Kudo. I know from jolly old England. And brother Lou. What's up, man? Should be playing some Richie Valens for you, I know. But hey, hope your birthday was phenomenal, and hope today's phenomenal. And hope you have a wicked awesome day. And hey, party hard and enjoy celebrating like it's 1969, minus the acid. And cheers and beers to you. Next on the list, my man Josh Clegg. With a man with a great first name like that, you know he's a hell of a guy. And Josh is also a badass god. Hey, I'm in the house that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Oh, I know that's West Louisiana. Josh, haven't heard from you in a while. How you doing, man? Hope you're doing well. Hope your birthday was phenomenal yesterday. Definitely miss working with you. And brother, keep in touch, will you? So hey, celebrate well and enjoy. And brother, cheers and beers to you. Raven still at the ball. All right, next on the list, my good friend. Yana Capaccio, Yana Capaccio, of course, the wonderful better half of the amazing WGR 550 AM radio legend, Sal Capaccio, a wicked hardcore Buffalo Bills fan. And Yana, I know you are too, and you're an absolute sweetheart, and a gifted runner, gifted athlete, and happy birthday. Hope your birthday was phenomenal. You told me it was. No surprise there. I know Sal took you out to dinner. Swimming. Well, Yana, hope you had a wicked awesome day. Hope today's a wicked awesome day. And hey, celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers to you. And who do we have in the background? That's right, my very own daughter, Princess Delilah.
Look at what I missed. You messed with the cat toy.
You missed messing with the cat toy? Why?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. Well, don't forget your featured part of today's show, like you do every day, okay? So you can start researching. Of course, when Princess Delilah shows up on the show, you know it's a good day. All right, next birthday, my good friend Lori Pinkham. Now, here's a real sweetheart of a lady I've known for over 3 decades. Lori, final stand grader of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School, class of 1990, and she is absolutely phenomenal. And Lori, happy birthday from yesterday, and how you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope your birthday was phenomenal. Haven't heard from you in a while. Drop me a line. Let me know how you're doing. Hope you have a wicked awesome day and celebrate well and enjoy and cheers and beers for you. Wow, can I talk any faster? And then my man, Ruan Gorley. This guy, badass. Very good friend of mine. I've had as a friend on your Facebook for years. It all started out with Farmville, I believe. Now, Mafia Wars as well. Great keeping you around. You're a hell of a guy and brother. Happy birthday. And hope you have a wicked awesome day from yesterday and today as well. And celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers. And my brother just said to Mom cheats and bluff out. Wow. Interesting. Alright, well, next on the list, I knew it was Tawny Levitt. Tawny Fondren, happy birthday to you. From yesterday, how you doing? Hope you're doing well. Find out Sam Grider, Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1989, if I'm not mistaken. Of course, her awesome little brother, Jake, I graduated with in the greatest class ever, Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1991. The best damn graduating class in the history of mankind, womankind, and that kind. But Tawny, happy birthday from yesterday. Hope it was phenomenal and hope you have a wicked awesome day. Always great hearing from you. And celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers. Oh, I better answer my brother's text. I hate texting. Texting should be banned. Next birthday from yesterday, my good friend Stacy Heal. Now, I know Stacy, courtesy of my love goddess, Farrah. And, Stacy, haven't heard from you in a while. Love to hear from you. Happy birthday from yesterday. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Living in the greatest state in the nation, Massachusetts. Because without Massachusetts, there wouldn't be an America. Period. Dot. End of freaking story. Okay. We know that. And, Stacy, hope you had a phenomenal day. And hope you have a wicked awesome day again today. Hope you're a Patriots fan like Delilah and I are. Yeah. And celebrate well and enjoy it. Cheers and beers.
Oh, and Daddy?
Uh-huh.
There's actually some proof that without Massachusetts, there wouldn't be an America.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
That Massachusetts was one of the 13 colonies.
That's right. And that's where the revolution started.
Yep.
That's right.
Oh, wait. I found the Minecraft fact.
Oh, Minecraft fact of the day, Delilah. Take over. It's Delilah's portion. Go ahead.
If a creeper is struck by lightning, it becomes a charged creeper, which will make it even more dangerous and explosive. Stay away.
Good to know.
Oh, look. This is what it looks like.
Well, there you go.
It looks like this, but with lightning around it.
Wow. All right. And the final... No, that's it for the January 9th birthdays. Hot damn.
Yes, way up there in heaven.
Oh, my God. My friend Scotty Newman said that the Patriots are going to win 35-31. He said the Ravens are going to kick a field goal to make it 31-28 Ravens. And then the Patriots will come back to win 35-31 with a touchdown. Now, it's 28-28, and the Ravens are about to kick a field goal. Wow. We'll see if he's right. Scotty Newman, a wicked high school legit no bull Seattle Seahawks fan that I know from jolly old England. A spike chasing son of a gun. We'll see if you're right.
Brother Scotty.
Hell yeah. With that said, let's get to today's birthdays. And how about this one? My man, Jared Moyer. Jared Moyer, badass Age Ranger. Didn't star, because danger is no stranger to an Age Ranger, and I don't think you're a Rump Ranger. Brother, what a privilege, a pleasure, and honor to work with legends like you down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as is northern Mexico. That's right, pretty much the same damn country. Jared, my man, hey, hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. And you know what? Cheers and beers, my friend. Fulton Betancourt. Fulton Betancourt, a wonderful man. Martha's Vineyard Island, the greatest island in the world. Hell yeah. Fulton, what's going on, man? How are you? Happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. If I'm not mistaken, final senior graduate of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 2000. Wow. Am I correct on that? I believe I am. But Fulton, my man, hope your birthday's phenomenal. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. And hey, celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Now, how about somebody that was born the exact same month, day, and year as my good friend, Jared Moyer? Anang, is it John Cook or Jan Cook? J-A-N-C-U-K. Well, see, Anang is a fellow Mafia Wars player that I know online. And Anang, happy birthday to you. Hope you're doing well. I'll be on the old Mafia Wars to get rid of some pent-up frustration right after this show and right after dinner. Because I'll tell you what, even if my Patriots win, I'm still going to get rid of some pent-up frustration. Because I hate the Baltimore Ravens. But Anang, I love having partners like you in the old Mafia Wars. It's a lot of fun. Well, happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Excuse me. Celebrate, well, enjoy, and cheers and beers. All right, let's get to our next song, shall we? Damn right. Five-finger death punch. Death punch. Wrong Side of Heaven. Folks, this is a long one. And this song, I hope, doesn't get blocked on the old Facebook and YouTube by those copyright infringement Nazis. I hope it plays. Okay, I had to check and verificate, as opposed to defecate. I guess it starts off silent for a while. Well, shit. How about our next shout out for our birthdays for today? How about my good friend, Randy Schaffner? Randy Schaffner, a recent addition to the Mafia Wars crew. And happy birthday to you. And how you doing? Hope you're doing well. Haven't heard from you in a while. But I'd love to hear from you. As we love to ice fools on the old Mafia Wars. Teamwork makes the dream work. That's what we do. Great being part of your crew. Great having you as part of my crew. And Randy, my man, happy birthday. Hope you're having an awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, another mafioso on the old Mafia Wars. Daryl Silk, smooth as silk, quick like lightning, and ready to ice your ass. That's right, Daryl, and it's great having you in my crew, man. And happy birthday to you. And hope you're doing well. Hope you're celebrating it well. And hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. All right, now we got a couple birthdays that are absolute milestones. Now here's a real sweetheart of a lady and a great leader of men, women, and it celebrating a milestone birthday. My good friend, Patty Hickey, who I know from jolly old England. Living in Illinois. That's right. Western Indiana, pretty much the same state. Patty Hickey, you're an awesome lady, an awesome friend, and happy milestone birthday to you. How are you? Hope you're doing well, and hope you have a wicked awesome day. Milestone. Hell yeah! The new age bracket ain't bad. Trust me. I've been there for a while and I love it. So hey, celebrate well and enjoy. And by golly, cheers a beer to you, Patty. Hope you enjoy the show. And then to this good man, who was born the exact same month, day, and year as my good friend Patty Hickey. This wonderful man is a final senior graduate of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1993. My man Dave Burt, David Burt. Now, I graduated with his sister Jessica Burt in 1991, the best one ever. But, David, I haven't heard from you in a while. and I'd love to hear from you. Brother, drop me a line, let me know how you're doing. I never forgot your birthday from high school. I've known you for over 2 decades, and you're a hell of a guy. Brother, I hope you have a wicked awesome day, and happy milestone birthday to you. David, celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers, my friend. Alright. Now, our next birthday is my good friend, Dustin Still. Another mafioso on the old Mafia Wars. And Dustin's celebrating a milestone birthday. And Dustin, my friend, happy milestone birthday to you. The perfect age. You got that right. 25, man alive. You can rent a car from the airport now. Your insurance goes down. Excuse me. You're already drinking dope beverages? Damn right. Dustin. Excuse me. I wish I could stay 25 for the rest of my life. Hey, I'm 41 and a half years old. And I'm enjoying life. 25 plus 16 and a half. How about that, huh? But Dustin, hope your birthday's phenomenal. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. And celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers. And then to my man, KJ Rawson. That's R-A-W-S-O-N. KJ, longtime friend on the old Facebook Mafia Wars. I believe Farmville as well. KJ, haven't heard from you in a little bit, though. I'd love to hear from you, brother. Let me know how you're doing. And happy birthday to you. And hope you all have an awesome day. And celebrate well and enjoy. KJ Rawson, my friend. Cheers and beers to you. And to my good friend, the final birthday of the day, a lovely sweetheart of a lady, the honorable legend, Brenda Leonard. Brenda, what's going on, girl? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Missed the hell out of you. Never heard from you in a little while. Always a pleasure and a privilege and an honor to hear from you. Just an absolute legend on Martha's Vineyard Island. A real sweetheart. Brenda, my dear, happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day and celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers to you, my dear. Hell yeah. Alrighty. I do believe that's all the birthdays. Hot damn. Lots of shout outs. You know what? Let's bring out the next song of the day. Children of Bodom. Oh yeah. A nice angry band right here. Are you dead? Well, I don't know, New England Patriots. Are you dead? We shall find out soon. It's fourth quarter. The stupid, inbred, thuggish, douchebag, cocksuckers, Baltimore Ravens are up 31-28 right now. Scotty Newton, you better be right, brother. You better be right about the 35-31 New England Patriots victory. I hope to God you are. Otherwise, my friends, Dennis Guido Guidus, Tony the Tip Baronka, and Lori Bechet will be very happy. See, those three awesome friends of mine are all wicked hardcore, legit, no good Baltimore Ravens fans. Lori Bechet, a stunningly gorgeous sweetheart of a lady, and the better half of my good friend, Bill Bechet. Lori, I've known you for over 2 decades. You're amazing, you're awesome, a true Maryland girl, and you stick with your home team. Much respect. Although you're Baltimore Ravens, without kids, they deserve this. Period. I can't stand it. Tony and Tip Baronka. Brother, I love you like a brother. Not in that way. Not in the West Virginia way. Don't get emotional wreck. Tony and Tip Baronka. Formerly a badass bubble chasing legend of a man I worked with in jolly old England. Tony the Tip, living in Florida, the land of the old people. Oh, he's way too young to be a Florida guy. Originally from Maryland, hell of a man. Tony the Tip, dude, you're a hell of a guy, hell of a friend, and much respect to you. But I hate the Ravens. And you too, Cousin Guido. Cousin Guido, Dennis Guidus, a great leader of men and women in it, and a badass crew dog I know from exotic Japan. Guido, you stick with your home team as well. Much respect to you for that. But I hate your freaking Baltimore Ravens. And I got the Facebook bet going on with you that I think I lost. We shall see. But hey, to the three of you, you Baltimore Ravens legit fans, I say cheers and beers. Even though Terrell Suggs looks like a pile of after belts. And let's give a shout out to my good friend Kyle Solander. Kyle, dude, I got something in store for you in just a moment, so stay tuned. Folks, it is time for our vehicle of the day. And Kyle Solander, you requested it, and by God, the Love Doctor delivers for you. You wanted to see a 1969 Camaro Rally Sport Super Sport RSSS. 1969 Chevy Camaro RSSS is our vehicle of the day, our big song of the day. Ding-a-day, that is a very, very valuable automobile right there. And Kyle Solander, the pride of Washington State, otherwise known as Northern Oregon, and a wicked hardcore legit no big Denver Broncos fan. Kyle, my friend, that car is for you, my friend. Dude, you're a great fan of my show and page. You're a big-time sports fan like me. I met you through the NFL Red Zone Roundtable with our good friend Sal Paccio and the late, great Johnny Vaughn. I miss that guy so much. And Kyle, it's always great chatting with you, brother. And hey, you deserved it. You requested it for the beer song of the day. And brother, I'll drink to that, and you should too. All right. Let me give it up to my man, Sean Moody. A badass crew dog that I know from jolly old England and the pride of Vermont. That's right. Basically, Western New Hampshire. But Vermont is a great state. The Green Mountain State. Hell yeah. And Sean Moody and his wonderful, gorgeous, exquisite, wicked, awesome, better half, Jasna. Jasna, you're a real sweetheart. You take care of that man. And Sean, you better take care of her. Be a fellow New Englander like me and be a gentleman. Be a love doctor. Spoil Jasna the way she deserves. Sean, dude, we're wicked hardcore New England Patriots fans all the way. And the inbred Baltimore Ravens are up 31-28. The Patriots are driving downfield. Hot damn, we're in Baltimore territory. And we just got a first down. Yeah, I'm close to it, son of a bitch. I got to admit, I'm tired of hearing Chris Collinsworth. I loved him when he was with the Bengals as a wide receiver. And I used to like him as a commentator. But Chris Collinsworth, I think senility hit him early. Just saying. But Sean, or as I love to call you, Shauna, because it's a lot of fun. Dude, I miss the hell out of you. I miss working with you. Living in exotic Germany. Screaming. Sean Moody, who I worked with in jolly old England. Badass crew dog. Hell yeah. Sean, my friend, a big cheers and beers to you. And brother, go Patriots. Let's crush the Baltimore Ravens. All right. Bear with me, folks. I'm not as sober as I was when I started the show. But I got all the shout-outs out. It took 30 freaking minutes to do it. All right, almost 29. I'm getting text messages galore. Oh, God. Justin Dimmitt. Well, here we go. It is time for a hunk of the... Oh! Almost forgot to mention the trivia question. Holy shitballs. Folks, thank you Kevin Sherman of Kevin Ayers Booze and Metal Show. What I'm going to give a Ronnie James Dio inspired Love Doctor salute to at this time. Legendary question. What legendary heavy metal vocalist filled in on vocals for Black Sabbath when they agreed to support Ozzy Osbourne on his supposed farewell tour? Well, my good friend Ezra Agnew He's a final standing graduate of Monte Vineyard High School class of 1994. And Ezra, it's so great to hear from you, man. It's been too long, but great hearing from you. You nailed the trivia question. You said Rob Halford. And you are abso-frickin-smurfalutely correct. Wicked awesome job.
Oi, Big! Yeah, that's a salute to you. Oh, hell yeah!
Ezra Agnew, fine outstanding graduate of Monte Vineyard East High School class of 1994. Ezra, hell of a man. But hey, a lot of people thought it was Ronnie James Dio. Well, here's the gig. Ronnie James Dio refused to sing vocals for Black Sabbath when they opened for Ozzy. When Sabbath agreed to support former singer Ozzy Osbourne on his alleged retirement shows, recently returned singer Ronnie James Dio balked. Only for another metal god, Judas Priest legend Rob Halford, to fill in at short notice. So my metalhead friends, there you go. Now you understand why. It was not Ronnie James Dio, but Rob Halford. Okay? So with that said, speaking of Rob Halford, I got a treat for you. Let me hit up Justin Dimmitt real quick. Oh, shit. Cheaters? Justin Dimmitt calls them the cheaters. Hey, Justin! Hey, kids, look, a deer! Justin Dimmitt, I love you, man, but you hate my Patriots.
Jackass!
All right, let's bring out today's hunk of the day. That's right, and we're going to bring out a great song for this guy. Rob Halford. Rob Halford of Judas Priest, as we bring out All Guns Blazing, because my Patriots got All Guns Blazing right now. Rob Halford, this guy is a badass. This guy's a manimal. This guy freaking rocks. But what's interesting is a lot of people don't know this, but Rob Halford loves penises. He's gay. Didn't know you could be a badass and be gay now, did you? Now you know. Who cares if somebody's gay or lesbian? Who gives a shit, really? If they're happy, that's all that matters. Now, we had a lot of celebrity birthdays from yesterday and today. Let me bring out yesterday's birthdays. Kate Middleton, 33 years old. Jimmy Page. Of course, a Led Zeppelin. Now, some sources say 71 as of yesterday. Others say 70. Either way, Jimmy Page is a badass. Sean Paul. Badass rapper, 42 years old yesterday. 37th President of the United States of America. Richard Milhouse Nixon. Born January 9th, 1913, passed away in 1993 at the age of 80. Dave Matthews, of course, Dave Matthews Band. He's 48 and doing great. Bob Denver, we loved him. Gilligan's Island. Bob Denver, also on the TV show Dobie Gillis. Born January 9th, 1935, passed away at the age of 70 in 2005. Yeehaw country singer Crystal Gayle. Is 64 years old as of yesterday. I am the one who rocks. Yeah, you are there, Rob Halford. Bart Starr, legendary Green Bay Packers quarterback, 81 years old yesterday. Chad Johnson, Chad Ochocinco, Chad Ochocinco, Chad Man Previous Johnson, whatever you want to call him, 37 years old yesterday. Hippie singer Joan Baez, 74 years old yesterday. NASCAR badass Mike Martin, he turned 56 yesterday. Muggsy Bogues, Tyrone Muggsy Bogues, shortest player in NBA history at 5'3". He was a badass. 50 years old he was as of yesterday. Look at Rob Halford, how young he was there. Wow. Lara Fabian, model, hottie, 45, man alive, wicked fine. Joey Lauren Adams, phenomenal, gorgeous actress, 47 years old as of yesterday. How about today's celebrity birthdays? Yeah, let's get cracking. And let's drink while we do that. Patriots up 35-31. Come on, Patriots defense, show up, damn it. Oh, they did. They crushed Joe Flacco. Yeah, sorry, kids. That's why I like to call him Joe Flacco. The hell with Joe Flacco. Or Flaccid. I hate that son of a bitch. I like Rob Halford, though.
Hell yeah.
How about this, Sean Moody? Huh?
Yeah.
Today's celebrity birthday are Hrithik Roshan, 41 years old, actor, badass. How about Rod Stewart, a very flamboyant and unique singer, 70 years old today, a true legend. I love his song Maggie May, but Rod Stewart, not a big fan of him overall, but dude's got a lot more money than I'll ever have, probably. How about Tamina Snuka, of course, a legendary daughter of the true wrestling legend, Jimmy Superfly Snuka. Tamina Snuka, a legend in her own right, 37, and a gift sent from heaven. Pat Benatar. Folks, Pat Benatar, one of the true queens of rock and roll. Pat Benatar, 62 years old, looking fantastic for her age.
Rob Halford.
How about Grigory Rasputin, political leader of Russia, born this day in 1869, passed away in 1916, and he's the icon of Old Rasputin Imperial Russian Stout, a great beer out of Fort Bragg, California. George Foreman, the legendary George Foreman boxer, and of course, famous for his George Foreman grill, 66 years old today, big fan of him. Another one that was also born January 10th, 1949, sadly no longer with us, is the legendary porn star Linda Lovelace, who passed away in 2002. But yeah, she would be 66 years old today if she was still with us. Ray Bolger, phenomenal actor, originally from Massachusetts, played the Scarecrow in the 1939 classic Wizard of Oz. He was born in the state in 1904, passed away in 1987. Former Major League pitcher, predominantly with the Chicago White Sox, Rich Dotson, 56 years old today. Sarah Sheahy, phenomenal model, 35, man alive, we can find. Former boxer, legendary badass middleweight, Felix Trinidad. Felix Trinidad is 42 years old today. Jim Croce, famous for Bad Bad Leroy Brown, baddest man in the whole damn town. Born on this day in 1943, perished in a plane crash September 20th, 1973, at the much too young age of 30 years old. Sal Mineo, phenomenal actor, born on this day in 1939, was murdered in 1976 at the much too young age of 37. Frank Sinatra Jr., thankfully he's still with us, 71 years old today. Donald Fagen, singer, 67 years old. Ann Poulter, golfer, 39. How about that? Roy E. Disney, of course, the nephew of the late, great Walt Disney and the son of Roy O. Disney. He was born in the state in 1930, passed away in 2009. Jake DeLone, remember him? Carolina Panthers quarterback, 40 years old today. Milestone birthday to him. I know people that are 40 years old today. That's pretty damn cool. First baseman legend of the San Francisco baseball Giants, Willie McCovey, 77 years old today. Late great actor Paul Henreid, H-E-N-R-E-I-D. Paul, is it Henreid or Henreid? I don't know. Born in the state in 1908, passed away in 1992. And finally, late great singer Johnny Ray. Born on this day in 1927, passed away much too young at the age of 63 in 1990. Of course, with his famous song, Cry, in 1951. A phenomenal ballad singer, Johnny Ray. That's J-O-H-N-N-I-E, Ray, R-A-Y. And what a badass Rob Halford is, huh?
Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. You know what a good hunk of the day is all about earlier.
Whoops. Like I said, I wasn't going to be sober by the time I get done with this here show. Alright, time for my favorite part of the show, the babe of the day. And folks, this girl freaking rocks. It's been a long time since I've had her as babe of the day. But I don't think you're going to be disappointed. As we bring out the totally bodacious, tattooed Megan Daniels. Hot diggity dog damn. She's hot, real hot, damn hot, wicked hot, and smoking hot. So finally, a new set of snow tires, and let's bring out the final song of the day. Watch your ears, kids. The song's called Pussy Liquor. That's L-I-Q-U-O-R. Pussy.
Meow.
Pussy Liquor, or Liquor, by Rob Zombie. Here you go. Great song. For Babe of the Day, Megan Daniels. A lot of people will post up on my page right now. 35-31 Patriots, Joe Flacco, Joe Fucker, Joe Flacker, driving downfield. 2 minutes left. I'm getting worried. Come on, Patriots defense. Put your head out of your ass. Gotta stop them. A lot of cool things happened on this day, January 10th, in the year of our Lord, whenever. I say 1997, 4,000th episode of Entertainment Tonight was broadcast. I say 1995, the Late Late Show with Tom Snyder premiered on CBS TV at 12:30 in the morning. 20 years ago today, wow. I remember when the show came out. I say 1984, we remember the commercial, don't we? Where's the beef? Clara Peller with the Wendy's commercial. Where's the beef? That commercial was aired 31 years ago today. Honestly, in 1982, 17 degrees Fahrenheit, 27.2 degrees below zero Celsius for my metric friends in Braemar, Grampian, United Kingdom. That equals the UK record for the lowest temperature of all time. Metric friends. Eh, that's what I'm talking about. Oh, Canada, indeed. I guess a lot of our neighbors up north. That's right. Without them, we wouldn't have hockey. On say 1981, John Severin sets a 100-mile unicycle speed record. He did it in 9 hours and 21 minutes. Wow. He rode more than 20 miles per hour on a freaking unicycle. I can't even ride a unicycle, folks. Whoa. Honestly, 1980, the last broadcast of The Rockford Files on NBC TV. Also on this day in 1980, Jim Stewart, Boston Bruins rookie goalie, allows 3 goals in his first 4 minutes and a total of 5 in the first period. Thankfully, he never played again in the NHL. Man, he sucked. Honestly, 1967, PBS, the public broadcasting system, National Educational Television, begins as a 70-station network. On this day in 1951, the first jet passenger trip made. How about that? Passenger trip? Wow, that's nice. On this day in 1949, the day that George Foreman was born, the first Jewish family show, The Goldbergs, premieres on CBS television. Also on this day in 1949, the day that Linda Lovelace and George Foreman were born, the RCA introduces the 45 RPM record, the little 45, better than the 78, more unbreakable. On this day in 1912, the world's first flying boat had their maiden flight by Glenn Curtis in New York. On this day in 1911, the first photo in the United States taken from an airplane. And that was in San Diego, California, the land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon. On this day in 1901, oil was discovered in Texas. Yeehaw, Texas! Otherwise known as Eastern New Mexico, pretty much the same state, minus the oil. On this day in 1870, speaking of oil, John D. Rockefeller incorporates Standard Oil. Wow. On this day in 1863, London's first subway opens. How about that? The London Underground. First subway in the world. On this day in 1839, tea from India first arrives in the United Kingdom. You know why the Brits love their tea? They got it from India. How about that? Finally, on this day in 1776, common sense, something that the United States needs to learn again. Maybe they should read it. Common Sense by Thomas Paine is first published. Common sense. Folks, drink the common sense. I never used to have it. I've learned it over the years. Others need to do the same.
Son of a bitch, the Ravens just scored a touchdown.
A minute and 39 seconds to go.
Wait a minute. Patriots intercepted it.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, folks. Bear with me, okay? When you got a Patriots game going on like this against the evil, inbred, douchebag, cocksucker Baltimore Ravens, interruptions are going to happen. Let's drink to the New England Patriots. Watch out, kids. Block your ears. The same way you censor, folks. Hey! Fuck you, Joe Flacco, you jackass! The Ravens can only stop the clock one time. The New England Patriots may win 35-31. Scotty Newton. All right, you called it. Scotty Newton, you called it. You said 35-31 Patriots after a Ravens field goal and a New England Patriots drive downfield to seal the deal. Scotty Newton, my friend, I'm going to give you the love dot to salute. Whoa! Hell yeah! Scotty Newton, dude, we need more like you in the world. So you gotta do me a favor, alright? Be fruitful and multiply. Have a litter of kids, will ya? Hey, Baltimore Ravens! Watch out, kids. Block your ears. And same with you, sensitive ears. Fuck you, Baltimore Ravens! Hate the Baltimore Ravens, cocksuckers. Wow. All right, I don't like to drop the F-bomb a lot on my shows, but today, who gives a fuck, right? Screw it. It's Smash Metal Saturday. And I gotta admit, I had given up on the Patriots. I thought they were gonna lose. They proved me wrong. Way to go. And there's a lot of action going on. And I don't know what the hell I just did. Thank God it's still going. So let's continue to drool over Megan Daniels. I have Babe of the Day on Baron Song of the Day. Big and A. Let's finish the show out strong. Let's finish the football game out strong. Wow, there's a lot of action going on my Facebook right now. But you know what? I'm too busy recording the show. Sorry, friends. Hot damn. There's a lot of anger going on in the old Facebook. Ooh, damn. Megan Daniels, been a long time since we featured her, but that's the last picture of the day. Folks, let's take this beer home so I can get back on the old Facebook with my friends. Let's slam it home, suckers. Empty the brain cells of an average Yankee fan. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. First time to make the fetus a head out. Somebody take care of it. Have a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive, man. Spill your drink. All you might kill yourself or ask somebody else and drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. What's dumber than that is rooting for puke-infested Cooper schnitzels like Eli.
I'm a good Tom Brady.
Oh, yeah. You're in the playoffs this year, right? Jackass, Manning,
or men slapping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people who watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports the fans or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid and definitely deserve a very fat GFY and a big fuck you. Folks, apologize, but I had to drop the F-bomb today. Today's show was a lot of anger, a lot of hostility. Still a lot of fun, though. I'll holler at y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye, Ravens. Go fuck your mother, you pricks. I hate the Baltimore Ravens. I do.